Welcome to The Topic, where we highlight Houston Community College, our students, our programs, and our reach into the community. I'm Todd Duplantis. If you're watching us on YouTube, social media, or HCC TV, make sure you subscribe to our podcast on Apple iTunes podcasts, or you can download them at hccs.edu/podcast. Regularly on The Topic, we like to take the rounds around the whole district, and today we're talking the Southeast College. What's going on the campuses of the Southeast College? No better person to ask than Student Life Coordinator Armando Galvan-Cruzes. Thanks for being here.
Thank you, Todd, for the invitation. I'm so excited to be here today.
Now, Student Life, how active are you guys out there at the Southeast College?
We're extremely active. We currently have approximately one or two events a week for students,
right,
so they can be more engaged with the campus, and they get more involved every time.
And what's the reaction usually when students coming in? Are they wanting to get involved, and how important is it for them to get involved with you guys?
They want to get involved, and they want to interact with staff and also with different events we have.
Right.
Currently, we're having more events in regards to academics and learning more about their campuses, but also we like to have fun events that make students interested of what's going on campus.
Now we've got, we're just wrapping up a semester right now. We've got 2020 right around the corner.
Yes.
Hard to believe it's already here. As we jump into the semester, what are some of the activities that students can look forward to at the start of semesters?
Yeah, definitely. We have Welcome Week. Welcome Week is one of our biggest initiatives,
right,
that we have there at the beginning of the semester. We have Valentine's Day events. We have Martin Luther King events. We have Black History Month starting the semester. So there's a multiple amount of initiatives,
right,
and it's a matter of how students want to get involved and if they're how they want to participate. So there's different ways they can participate. They can become student leaders.
Right.
They can get involved in student organizations. They can plan those events. Here we are as Student Life Coordinators to facilitate those things, and they are the ones that have the voice.
If they want to get involved in student government, can they go through you guys to point them in that direction?
Yeah, definitely. We can have them started by knowing their current SGA presidents,
right,
and officers. For this semester, that's most of the officers are already set, but they can actually learn from them so they can participate next semester on,
right,
elections for SGA. But definitely, today is the day so they can start learning about those initiatives.
You guys have an interesting initiative I want to learn more about. It's called Conversation, yes, Corner. What is that about?
Conversation Corner. So Conversation Corner started by having real conversations. So we were discussing with students about how can we show what we have to offer here at HEC,
right,
to our students. So the way we kind of developed it was bringing up from the Learning Hub, where we have all our administrative operations, to the Student Life Center. So we bring managers,
mm-hmm,
we bring people in charge of those departments, and people that are actively involved in those departments to come to our students, where our students are, to learn about those departments. So it's kind of shifting the roles instead of,
right,
students going there, administration coming to the Student Life Center.
So you're giving the students more of an interactive experience with like student services and financial aid, anything they may have questions on, you can have the experts there to answer those.
Exactly, and the good thing of those conversation corners is that students open more.
Right.
They feel comfortable in that environment, so they're willing to ask questions that they are not sometimes comfortable on sharing at the offices, at the administration offices.
I'm asking you a couple of questions. What's, first off, the biggest question you get in student life from students when starting off at HCC? What's the first question they ask you?
How can I get involved?
How can I get involved?
How can I participate?
Mm-hmm.
So, and it's pretty simple. My answer for them is, you're in the right place. You just ask the question you need to ask. So come to the Student Life Center, participate in those activities, and we'll guide you. We know sometimes you don't know about the requirements, the processes, but that's what we are here for as Student Life Coordinators and at the Student Life Center.
What is the biggest misconception students may have when starting at HCC?
I think the biggest misconception is that it's too hard to participate.
Okay.
Or that you can't participate, mm-hmm, on things because, for example, SGA.
Yep.
So they need a specific GPA for participating on SGA. It's true, but that doesn't mean you can be part of it. So we try to, like, kind of clear out those misconceptions that it's hard to participate, getting involved, and facilitate those things.
So getting involved, you don't need to have a specific GPA to get involved, you know? And you encourage that, you know, because you're going to be hanging out more on campus, maybe hitting the library a little bit more and studying more if you need to bring that GPA up.
And kind of that's the goal of it.
Right.
If you get involved on organizations, on campus, you know where to go when you need help. Besides, if you're not part of the campus or just commuting to campus, then you don't know where to get help when needed. So that's
you brought up a good point, because a lot of times students just don't know the answer on where to go. If someone is looking to, say, get some tutoring or they want to bring up their GPA, can they go to you guys and can you point them in the right direction?
Yeah, that's what we're here for, to guide them on the right direction so they can improve their student experience. At the end of the day, we're looking for them to get the best student experience ever.
Now, how many members do you have working with you, and are these staff positions or are they volunteers that help you out?
It's an array of things. We have from work-study students, we have part-timers, we also have a couple of full-timers working at the center, and we have students who are our leaders, and they want to just participate, and they volunteer. Also, we have honor college students are participating on our event. So it's a multiple array of individuals that participate and are part of our center.
You brought up work-study students, and it's real important. So if someone, work-study is great, I think, is a great deal, because you get a chance to choose the departments at HCC where you want to go work for as part of your financial aid. If someone is thinking career-wise, which type of career would you steer them towards to go through student life? What career would that help you with by being a part of student life and working with you guys?
That's a great question. I don't feel like there's a specific type of career that it's good. I think involving on the Student Life Center, it helps you on your soft skills mainly. So if you're looking for a leadership position, how to interact with other people, working at the Student Life Center is just a great place to start. Either if you're going to a medical field or if you're going to business, it's good to have those interactions with other students that you don't know where they're going to end up.
Right. And I imagine it's also a great experience to walk out of student life and to know that you took part in these events and you helped out with these holiday events that you have. Because I know you guys have a number of things going on across the campuses. It must be really rewarding to the students at the end of the semester.
That's great. It's all about creating legacy. And I think our students are creating legacy today.
Armando Galvan Cruzes, thanks for being here on The Topic and telling us about student life at Southeast College.
No, thank you so much. Thank you for the invitation.
Absolutely. If you want to know more, you can go to the website, go to hccs.edu, search student life, and you can find information at Southeast College,
yes,
correct?
Yes, that's correct.
Thanks for being here. We'll be back and talk more about continuing education at the Southeast College when we return on The Topic.
This is Daniel. On his way to becoming a rock star, he got burned, literally. So he changed his tune and his career, and he's starting at Houston Community College. HCC, for everyone, anytime. This is Mac. She's ready to build herself a house and a business. But first, she's building her resume with a construction certification from Houston Community College. HCC, for everyone, anytime.
Welcome back to The Topic. I'm Todd Duplantis. The days have changed as far as business and having one degree or one certification and it lasting you throughout your whole career. We now need to be lifelong learners, and Houston Community College specializes in that with our continuing education department and programs. Joining me now is ML Young, and you're the program coordinator for the business continuing education program, correct?
Yes, that's correct, Todd.
Well, thanks for being here on The Topic.
Thank you for having us.
Now, tell me first off what your department entails as far as certifications. Does someone need to have a degree to go into your department? Can they come into your department and get education straight out of high school? What is the details involving that?
Okay, good questions. So typically our normal continuing education student is a multifaceted student. So we have students who start off as individuals who are trying to retool themselves into the workplace.
Okay.
We have individuals who come with undergrads, master degrees, and we also have individuals who are looking for changes, skill set changes,
right,
in their particular positions.
Do you find some of your students have been laid off at other jobs and you're looking to get retrained, either learn more or start another career?
That's, yes, oftentimes we'll see that. Also, another audience is individuals who maybe stay-at-home moms who've,
right,
been at home for several years and want to come back and reskill themselves or retool themselves for a new type of position in the workplace.
Let's say someone has been in a career for 20 years. They're not going to make any more money, and they're kind of discouraged by it, and they're losing faith in their career, and they want to do something different. They go into you. What are the steps they need to take? I'm not quite sure what I'm doing. I've been doing accounting or an accounting assistant for so many years. What can you help them out with?
Well, that's the question we hear a lot, and the question is, what else can I do now that I'm grown up?
Yeah.
So we just try to sit down with the students and see what their strengths are in some of their skill, mm-hmm, their current skill sets. Oftentimes, it's just simple as adding certification onto maybe their degree that they already currently have to add value to build up their resume with that,
right,
particular employer, or individuals who maybe they were a receptionist for a while and we can bring them into an accounting program, mm-hmm, to add value to their already basic skill sets.
Do you find some that are employed, they just want to make some more money and they need that extra certification maybe to get to a different pay grade? Do you have some people coming in like that?
Yes, we also have that. And what happens here, several of our programs have nationally recognized certifications.
Okay.
So they'll complete the training with HCC and then go on to get that certification, which does add value, and oftentimes their employer will give them an increase in pay.
Say someone comes in and they want to get a certification, but they also may want to look for another job. Can you help them with that?
Yes. We have not... Even though I'm the director of business programs, mm-hmm, let me just explain. Continuing education at HCC has multiple content areas.
Okay.
So we have business, we have construction, we have IT, health careers. So even though they may be coming into our office for business, we can discuss the whole platform of offerings to any of the students.
Can they go to any college or any of our campuses to take these classes, or do they have to go to one specific campus?
At different times, the schedule may vary. We try to offer them at a wide variety of our campuses.
Right.
Most of our key offerings that we offer are offered at our Southeast campus, but we also have offerings at West Loop, Northwest, and also Northeast.
Do these type of courses qualify for any financial aid? Can they get a Pell Grant? Can they get scholarships? Are those available?
In continuing education, we have programs that are considered marketable skills programs that individuals that within the city of Houston, TWC has said these particular skill sets, mm-hmm, are what's in demand.
And you're talking Texas Workforce Commission.
Yes, okay. Yes, I'm sorry, right. Thank,
yeah,
you.
Okay.
So those particular programs are programs that they can get financial aid for. Also within continuing education, mm-hmm. you'll see that there are certain scholarships for certain programs.
Depending on which one you go
in. Yes, sure, yes. Sure. And in addition, most of the continuing education class can be paid on a payment basis. So you can set up a payment plan.
Yes, as well. Yes. If it's not covered by any scholarships or financial aid.
Exactly.
Okay. Another concern people may have is, I work 10 to 6 every day. I've got kids. I want to go back to school, but I really only have time on the weekends. Can you help me out with that?
And we understand that, and we have something for those students. Majority of our classes are in the afternoons, in the evenings, so after 6, so even if you're trying to do that after work, and then a variety of classes we do offer on Saturday. So we have a weekend and an evening meeting pattern available to our CE students.
What are the age range of your students? Would I be intimidated if I go in and I'm a 50-some-odd-year-old guy and I'm just looking to get another certification? Am I going to be intimidated by these young kids that are in there?
No. You'll actually fit in. Most of our students are a little bit older.
Sure.
So I'm just going to say 30-plus. And they've either had some experience in the workforce and are simply just trying to retool themselves.
If you're looking to take a course, what would you say are some of the most popular courses and the most popular programs that you would direct people to and that are in high demand right now?
A couple of them in general. We've just started at Southeast, at our mm-hmm. Southeast campus, we've just started a forklift class.
Forklift technology.
Yes.
You're very familiar with that.
Yes,
yeah,
yeah. Yes.
We've done reports on that. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And so that class it really speaks to individuals who may be in the welding business and just they want to add a value to their welding component and they pick up our forklift class. We offer our forklift class. It's a total of 14 hours. It meets, our standard meeting pattern is it meets 2 Saturdays back to back.
So you can get it done in a couple of weeks.
And yes.
You get the certification. Mm-hmm. And do you have employers come in looking for that? I mean, I imagine that's in high demand right now.
It is, especially in the Southeast area. So yes, we do have employers who want that particular certificate. So they earn a certificate of completion, and we also produce their forklift ID badge, and they're ready to go to the workforce.
And you mentioned something being at the Southeast College. You guys are right next to the Port of Houston.
Yes.
A lot of jobs there as well, and I imagine they need people driving forklifts over there too.
Yes, definitely.
ML Young, thanks for joining us here on the topic and telling us more about continuing education. Never too old to keep learning, correct?
That's correct.
If you'd like more information, log on to our website, search Continuing Education, and you can find all the programs. When we come back, we're going to talk banking. Stay with us on The Time.
This is Ronick. She's a mom with a physics degree, so she understands the power of momentum. And she knows that by learning English at Houston Community College, she'll be unstoppable. HCC, for everyone, anytime.
I've seen people's lives changed just by attending a class at HCC.
Some of them might not have the financial means to go to a four-year university. That doesn't make them any less, quote-unquote, smart than the kids who go to a four-year school.
HCC is easy to get to. It's easy to apply and easy to become a part of.
It gave me so much confidence.
Once you finish your 2 years there, you can transition into a four-year university or go into the workforce.
It's affordable, it's accessible, it changes lives.
We have academic programs that help students get from high school into a university. And the data is very clear that students that take the path of a community college finish in far higher numbers than students that start straight into a university experience. Our students can achieve a baccalaureate degree in multiple fields from the universities in the area without ever leaving Houston Community College.
Meet Elizabeth. She's a mom on her way to get groceries. She's also on her way to getting an associate's degree at Houston Community College that could help provide for her family. HCC, for everyone, anytime.
Welcome back to the topic. Now, I know we've all been there. It happened to me just earlier this week. You're on the phone trying to get an answer from your bank, and you just keep getting an automated system, and you just want to talk with a real person. Where are the bank tellers these days? Well, they're here. In fact, there's a need for them, and we're here to talk with Janet Parr from HCC's Banking and Finance Program. Thanks for being here.
Thank you, Todd.
And you're going to talk to us about the Bank Teller Training Program, and I'm very excited about this because we were just discussing how impersonal banking has gotten over the years.
Well, and part of that is due to technology.
Sure.
The bank teller program that we have at HCC is one that trains actual people
Sure. Then
to be on that front line, sort of, to speak in banking and talk with customers. And, you know, we have a concept, I think, of what tellers are,
Right. Probably
from the history that we have with them. And what are they doing? They're accepting deposits from us and cashing our checks. But, of course, just as the financial industry and the needs of customers have changed, that position is changing as well.
And tell us exactly, it's fascinating, how is the position changing? What are bank tellers needing to know nowadays that they didn't need to know in 2000 or 1995 or 1990?
I think they have to know a lot more information because their job is expanding, their job duties are expanding, and a lot of banks don't even call their tellers teller anymore.
Right.
I tell my students in the teller training program, when we're looking at job opportunities, don't just look for the name teller. You have to look at the job description because one bank here calls it client associate.
Mm-hmm.
I'm trying to think of other names,
Yeah. But
there are a lot of them out there,
Yeah. And
it's because they've expanded that role. So think about the personal banker role, if you
right.
will. The teller role is kind of broadening to more like that. Universal banker is a title that a lot of banks use for tellers, and it speaks to the fact that not only will they be doing those traditional things like taking your deposits
Right. And
cashing checks, but now they're going to be helping you open accounts. They're going to be talking to you about other products and services that might be helpful.
Well, that's what I was going to ask you next. Are they going to be expected in the future to sell these products for the bank? Because that's how the banks are making their money these days. They have to sell these new products to keep it viable for them to stay in business.
Yes, they are going to be selling those. And in the Bank Teller program, we have three courses, and one of them is entitled Selling Bank Financial Service Products.
Okay.
So there's a focus on that because that's what's needed. Yes. Customers a lot of times don't even know what products or services might be helpful to them. So the job includes a need to understand all of the different products, listen to what the customers need,
Right. And
then try to help them find financial solutions. That's what customers want, not products.
Sure.
Solutions.
If someone is looking to get into this program, is this a stackable program where you can go into something else?
Yes, in a way it is. We have the certificate set up with three courses,
Okay. Which
is teller training, teller lab, where the students are putting into practice what they've been learning, and selling bank products and services. The selling bank products and services course is also part of our larger AAS degree, the two-year degree,
Okay. And
part of two other certificates we offer, which is the Financial Operations Certificate and the Financial Lending Certificate.
If someone wants to get into this program, they may be saying, well, bank teller is going to be gone in 10 years, but what you're telling us, there's always going to be a need for that personal contact, and that's what we're training. Do you see the name of the program maybe changing in the future from bank teller training?
It is interesting that you've said that, because we have an advisory board with representatives for about 10 local financial institutions
mm-hmm.
that they, one of their purposes is to tell us what do we need to be teaching to be
Right. Relevant
today. And we had that very same discussion because someone said, should we change the name of it to something different? And the consensus was no. The consensus among those bankers was no, don't change it, leave it teller, because it's a name that's easily recognizable.
Sure.
And they're saying to me, we still need tellers. Now, some
Yeah. Are
saying, we just don't call them that anymore.
Right.
But we still need that position.
It's a job description, but it's not necessarily the job title that they're going to go working for.
That's correct.
You mentioned advisory board, which is real important, because I know with Houston Community College, it's very important to establish those advisory boards to tell us what we're doing right and what we need to do to keep training the workforce. What's the job possibilities out there for now if you're coming through this program?
The job possibilities are great. HCC, of course, keeps statistics on these kinds
Yep.
of things, and whenever I get a vitality report, it says that overall in our program, now that includes other certificates, but overall in our program, we have like a 98 to 99% placement rate. I receive in the email every day from, I guess, Indeed and other sources, teller job openings here in the Houston area. So there's a constant need. I get banks that call me and say, hey, Janet, we've got some positions open. What about your students? So there's a constant need for it. There's a constant and continuing need.
If someone wants to start off as a teller, would this be a good stepping stone to see if you like the banking industry? Can you move on to be a loan officer or even being trained to move up in administration of the bank?
Yes, yes. Banking historically is one of the areas that tends to promote from within.
Right.
Many banks have already on their website what the career path might be for someone. So yes, and that's something that we've seen over and over again with our students. And in fact, some of our students, when they complete the program, I think because of the nature of the program and the scope of the training that they get, some are hired not as tellers, but based on their previous work experience, hired in other areas. I can think of one student, and he was hired as a personal banker out of the teller training program.
Yeah.
But he had some background that led them to think he'd be good in that position.
When you're hired as a personal banker, is that also a sales job? And do you make a commission? Do these folks make commissions off of what they're getting as investments?
It depends on how the bank structures their pay. So there might be some pay incentives. And I will tell you, some banks do not use the word selling.
Right.
Okay, they don't. Because I think because the general public sometimes has sort of a negative attitude about, we've had a bad sales experience somewhere, so, I don't know.
Right.
But promoting products, you know, it really is about listening to your customer and what is it they need? Not what do we have that we want to give them, but what do they need that we have? It's got to meet the customer's needs.
If a student is graduating from high school, not quite sure which direction to go, the parents are thinking of getting them into HCC or a community college, would this be a good route if you want to get your student or your child involved in the banking industry?
Absolutely. I think it's a great route because our program is 8 weeks long.
That's so, 8 weeks.
8 weeks.
Wow.
In 8 weeks, three courses, 9 semester hours of credit. And the idea is, let's get you trained with the skills you need today so that when you finish in 8 weeks, the idea is start going to work in the banking industry in this entry-level position. And then it may be something that you build a career from, which I can think of a lot of our students who have built careers from it, stayed in the banking industry. They found they liked it. I could think of one lady who found she liked it. She continued on. She became the executive vice president of the particular bank that she worked at most recently. And we've had other stories like that. One student became the CEO of a credit union, and she began in teller training. So
you always hear those stories of working your way up through the company, and this is a great way to start. Janet Parr from the Banking and Finance Department, Southeast College, thank you for being here on The Topic.
Thank you.
And thank you for joining us today. Remember, download our podcasts on Apple Podcasts or at hccs.edu/podcast. For The Topic on HCC TV, I'm Todd Duplantis. I'll see you next time.